You talked about virtue and some fundamental beliefs of values need to be in a society.
Right.
And you kind of assume it as Christian values because there are other values too.
Yeah.
Like I talked to people of Iran. I say, we are not ready for democracy because the value system comes from Islam. Islam means one individual is not important. Democracy says one person is important.
Yeah.
Jesus says one person is important.
That, well, that's big. No, this is a big thing, is that the God you worship, you know, people talk about God, which God?
Yeah.
Which God? Because many people around the world, they talk about God. The Christian idea of God, and I mean the pure Christian idea, because you can even have within Christianity people twisting things. So we're talking about what the Bible says about the individual is radical. It says God died for you, not for humanity, for you, like you're his son or you're his daughter. And so the value of the individual is key also to American democracy, in the sense it says that the majority cannot crush the individual.
That's
Even if people vote and say, we all agree on this, they have to first ask themselves the question, is this a just law? Are you persecuting one or two people? So how do you have majority rules, but how do you protect the individuals if the majority decides to go in the wrong direction? This is why you need a constitution like the American Constitution and a very clear view. I mean, it starts in English law, but in the American Declaration and in the Constitution and in some of our subsequent speeches and things, Lincoln understood this brilliantly. You get this beautiful idea that is very rare. It's very rare, and it's fragile. And the only way really for it to continue is if people understand it and live it out and celebrate it. I mean, if you leave it alone, we'll just all go back to some kind of oppressive government. And I think that America has been sliding in this direction, but the people in America are waking up. And every time I get an opportunity, I'm talking to them about
these ideas. That's why, you talk on your shows and all that, and appreciate that. About the values, I talk to our people and say, I'm not anti-Islamic. I'm just realistic. This type of theology does not match democracy.
Cannot.
You see that.
Well, it can't.
You know, America tried to import democracy to Iraq, Afghanistan.
Yes.
It doesn't work.
Listen, I've spoken about this. In fact, I touch on it in my book, if you can keep it. But I saw this a few years ago. I said, you know what? The people who brought about the Iraq War and stuff, they were naive. And they didn't understand what we're talking about. They thought, get rid of the dictator, here comes democracy. Yeah. No way. No way. That doesn't happen. This is naive. The people have to be trained to govern themselves.
That's right.
They have to understand how it works. If they don't understand that, they're not going to know. It's like giving a gun to a three-year-old.
That's right.
He is not equipped for this. He has to be trained. This is fragile.
Just respecting other people's opinion. That's Christian value.
See, this is the other thing, too. And in a funny way, because we have to be honest, historically, Christians didn't get this. In other words, if you go back to 1400, the Christians were oppressive with the Christian faith.
Right.
They forced the Christian faith. It took time for the ideas of the gospel to work its way into government.
Yeah.
And you get, Luther kind of gets you closer, but Luther didn't understand it.
Yeah.
But when you get to America around 1776, they finally figured out, how can we have a system that honors God, that honors people who don't believe in God, that honors people that love God, how do we do this? And all those ideas come out of the Bible. But it's very easy for people to use the Bible for their own, you know, things and stuff. So when you talk about values, I guess I'm thinking about, there's the one thing that the Christian faith has is called grace. It's called loving our enemies. And so that even if we disagree, we can still be respectful and love each other. So it's not about right and wrong.
Right.
It's right and wrong is real, but we also have to have a way when we disagree, how do we function? And that's part of what I would call Christian culture, that the Christian faith cannot be forced.
Amen.
And if you know that, then you understand that it's antithetical to that kind of government. The government has to be really respectful of people, that they can have their own faith. And I would say only the Christian faith It's a strong faith, but it also respects the freedom of those not that faith. So because I'm a Christian, I would never try to force my faith on someone with a different faith.
Amen.
Because I'm aware you cannot do it.
You cannot do
it. You can force the name. I could say, okay, now you're this, now you're this, now you're baptized. Yeah. But it's meaningless. But the real faith has to come from God.
Amen.
And so this is, to me, unique to Christianity. Definitely.
Amen.
Definitely. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Eric. You shared many great points. I took some notes.
Yeah.
I wish I had more, and I'm going to read your book. But the points you made clear, I'm sure our audience, our viewers benefit from that.
I'm excited.
Thank
I'm
you
very
so
excited
much
for Iran,
sharing that.
The future.
Amen. Yeah. Iran, as the Lord promises in Jeremiah 49:38, Iran will be transformed by the gospel.
Amen.
And it's going to impact not just the region, the whole world. That's written in the Bible. So
Amen.
We believe that, and it's going to happen. Well, thank you so much
you.
For being
bless
with us.
You.
God bless. Bye-bye.